Well, I'd like to ask both of you, first of all, what do you think of the Minneapolis police chief telling the court that Derek Chauvin did not follow department policy during the encounter with George Floyd?
I think he did right. He got up and spoke about what he has seen in the video. He's seen 9 minutes of torture. The people in the video also stated the same facts that he stated. The man was tortured to death and he should still be here. That is not proper policy. That is not the protocol that they follow. He should be incarcerated. He should be convicted. And the other officers that helped him do it, they should all be convicted with him.
Attorney Crump, how do you feel about the chief saying he didn't follow the policy for the department?
You know, I thought it was riveting and explosive testimony that completely destroys the defense, saying that he was following proper protocol. You know, hopefully you will always have police officers come and tell the truth, because we all saw the truth in the video, and we are so riveted that you actually have police officers coming in the courtroom telling the truth against officers who killed a black person, that it is something that is riveting to us when it should be normal. It really should be normal that when you see this type of injustice happen on video, there should not be anybody saying, oh, let's figure out a way to assassinate the character of the unarmed, unrestrained black person.
Let me ask you, gentlemen, after court today, you were walking in downtown Minneapolis with your fist up, and you got responses from the people in this city responding positive. How did that make you feel?
It made me feel wonderful. I just think about all the things that happened across the nation. So many people have stepped out. It's been a pandemic. COVID is killing people, but people are out fighting for their lives. They out here doing things that they don't have to do because, you know, they can stay at home. But my thing is, people put their lives on the line for what was right. And you have so many individuals that I'm grateful for. So I walk down the street with my hand held up high to show everybody that I was thankful, and we will have to do this again, not just for George, for others across America, because this is the never-ending cycle. That's the way it's looking.
Attorney Crump, how did that make you feel?
It made us know that there are people who believe that equal justice should be the norm, not the exception. And the fact that you have so many people who are saying, until we get justice for George Floyd, none of us can breathe. Black, white, brown, red, everybody is saying this was wrong.
Gentlemen, one last question. How are you both personally preparing for verdict day? For the verdict, how are you preparing yourself personally?
I'm taking it one day at a time. I talk to my family, and we pray on a lot of different things. And we have faith that we will get a conviction. This system will never break my faith. I'm here with one of the best lawyers ever put in a civil rights courtroom. You know, this is the man. He can talk to me about so much. And also Mr. Al Sharpton and Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee. You know, it's just different people who are up in different levels that I never thought that I would be able to meet. These people, man, they took me through it, showed me what was going on. And I just pray that everybody will understand that we will get justice.
Attorney Crump, how are you preparing?
Like Philonise, you know, there are times when our client really helps lead the path. And Philonise, with his faith as well as his humanity, he always talks about all of us coming together. And despite how disappointed you may be that they're assassinating the character of this black man who is his brother, if he can try to say it's about unity, then we all should follow his lead. It is about unity. And so that's how we're preparing for this verdict, that we're going to be unified and dignified, because that's what George Floyd would have wanted, and that's what Philonise Floyd wants.